Awkward Mafia.
Hello, internets. Welcome to an episode of Awkward Mafia Watches Something, while you watch us watch it.
While we're watching the watch. But who watches the Watchmen?
Nintendo? Is Nintendo Direct the April one? I don't know. They name these weird.
I'm sure
everything's good there. Good
I'm sure
here.
If the Watchmen uploaded Nintendo footage to YouTube, they'd probably watch them very closely.
Hmm.
They'd be like, all right, sorry. Sorry. Yeah. God, I want I was going to call him Rickshaw. Sorry, Rorschach.
Rickshaw?
You know those things that people run around?
Yeah, no, I know.
Sorry, Rickshaw.
Oh, here we go. E to M.
Rated everyone to
me. Man, they're going all in with Splatoon 2.
There's a lot of blood. They're putting a lot of effort to this direct startup thing.
Ah, they always do.
Not usually. They just be like, hello.
Yes, hi, everyone. Welcome to Nintendo Direct.
Hello.
I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi from Nintendo.
Hi, Yoshiaki.
I'll be your guide.
Who's this guy again? He's not the president.
No. He's like head of marketing or something, I think.
Products,
or product Switch. Design.
Today, we'll take a deeper dive into ARMS and Splatoon 2. But first, let's start with Nintendo 3DS.
Okay.
That's not the 3DS
right,
noise.
Time to speed run through some headlines. One fateful trip through the stars.
Hey,
okay.
Pikmin.
Hey, Pikmin, that's what it's called.
Hey, you, Pikachu.
Wait.
Oh, it's just like Castlevania, that one Lord of the Shadows game, right?
To grow in love. Hmm.
Why is he there now?
Shut up. Yes, too many questions, okay?
I mean, it seems like he goes to this planet he hates a lot.
He loves it.
There's only one way to find out. The Hey Pikmin game rockets onto
that's a good
the
name.
Nintendo 3DS family of systems July
28th. Hey, you Pikmin!
Day, the new Pikmin amiibo figure crops up on store shelves. In the run-up to launch,
that's a cool one.
We'll reveal
tap
more
in to
about
call back
amiibo
a Pikmin.
Functionality and what's in store for Olimar and his Pikmin.
Oh, this game. Yeah, it's been a while. This seems interesting.
He looks a bit tense. He's just like, stone fizz.
I'm holding this.
Hello. It is me.
I mean, I love the art.
Unique design.
It's like, RPG, Animal Crossing type of thing.
Yeah. A little bit of Monster Hunter.
Yeah, a little bit of Monster Hunter, a little bit of, probably Story of Seasons.
A little bit of Etrian Odyssey. Yeah. He's got horns on his hat, so. Is that like a normal thing, or is he like cursed like the people from.
I saw someone else with horns. So.
Like the guy from Eco? Or maybe these are. This covers up with Animal Crossing? At least they have
yeah, maybe everyone's part animal and he's just part ram.
No, part Animal Crossing. No, the humans had horns in the animal forest.
Hmm.
Hunting for something different? Monster Hunter Stories!
Oh! Though.
Well.
Story, that's the chibi one?
RPG adventure, I don't know. Like anything,
the monster yeah, it's someone with the head of the amiibos.
Hmm.
In Story,
oh, what?
Yeah.
A
and yeah, I know. Right?
I've been waiting for something like this in the actual game. It's like, you capture these monsters, why can't you tame one? And like, wow. Oh, wow. This is pretty cool.
There are three amiibos for it, I think?
And participate in turn-based
they'll probably say,
wow. I would not want to ride as an ogre.
Nope, didn't talk about the amiibos.
Yo-kai watch.
When something strange happens, we all know why. Yo-kai.
Something
but
strange?
You the first time,
in your neighborhood?
I'm trying to think of a funny way to say that. Something strange in your localization?
Yeah. In the community in which that you
in
live?
In your region? In your PAL region?
To the origin of Darknia.
Which one's in America? The third or fourth? One of I know one of them's set in America, and you're like a Ghostbuster in that one. Because that's what the equivalent in America is, right?
Fan things.
Yeah. Ghostbusters, right?
Yeah.
God, does Japan love Ghostbusters? It is weird how much they love that movie. I mean, it's a good movie, but like we don't even love it that much.
Ooh, Cold Stuff? So, if you like Monopoly or Fortune Street, Cold Stuff's totally up your alley.
Oh, yeah?
It's like tabletop card game battle Monopoly.
Oh.
Yeah. I mean, they haven't had a Cold Stuff game in a while. I think last one came out on 360.
popular card board game mashup. This is for their anniversary. It's releasing August 29th.
Mm. Standard and limited edition. I like Cold Tip.
Nearing an infinite amount of time waiting to be told. RPG Maker?
Festival? RPG
creation they usually don't dedicate time and directs for this sort of the game.
Elegant, graceful, and deadly.
Downloadable content will include crossover character skins.
Can you draw your own sprites?
Disgaea 5.
Wait, what?
So you can share the greatness of
they're having Disgaea characters in there?
Do that, I didn't see.
That's what they said. Because probably it's a Nisa game, so they're going to have crossover art and all the stuff they have.
That's cool.
Whether they own the full game or not, you can wield the full power of this incredible tool by purchasing the standard or limited edition when they launch in the U.S.
Okay. June 26th. I'm not a big fan of RPG Maker.
I would love that if I was a kid.
I don't like it mostly on consoles.
Yeah, exactly.
Quite like this before. In Miitopia, the Dark Lord has stolen the townspeople's
Bill! Is that Bill Trennan? It is him!
Save us up to Reggie to save the kingdom.
By customizing their personal traits, phrases, and jobs. As you journey across the land, your allies will bond.
Okay, so, you, Bill?
Like a more in-depth me RPG, or whatever it was. What was that one called? Me Castle?
Yeah.
Open up new areas of the map. The turn-based battles are straight out of the JRPG, except with a twist. Your allies have a mind of their own. The relationship will affect their performance.
They'll fight each other?
As their bonds deepen, they'll learn new abilities.
Once they like people.
Ah, so you gotta get S ranks with everyone so they'll cooperate. That's interesting.
Defeat an enemy and you'll earn XP.
Miyamoto!
Which you can use to unlock more abilities. Imagine casting one of your best friends as a gritty warrior, or seeing your boss as a pop star. In Miitopia,
yes, because I play games with my boss.
And many, many more.
No.
That might be
they don't know you're doing it. You just make one of your boss.
Fire Emblem Echoes, Shadows of Valentia will take the series back to its roots. When one
sort of. The roots?
Expand your adventure. Downloadable content.
I mean, technically it's the second route. So, I mean, it's a route.
But no matter what, you can expect new maps and dungeons that will test your strategic merit.
I don't know how to, so you just walk around?
The dungeon crawl and then eventually gives you like an instance battle, I believe.
You may even learn more about character backstories.
It's like Persona, but strategy RPG.
Okay.
In packs, or all at once through a season pass, so you can access each as
which season
is released. Keep your eyes on the horizon for full Oracle details, including release timing. This year marks Kirby's 25th anniversary.
Oh,
in celebration,
that seems sooner than
a few fun little surprises.
Yeah.
First, the team
wait, Kirby
Clash Deluxe
was around 2 years.
Oh, they created their own version of like the thing from the game.
I thought they already did that.
Yeah, but this is, I think, is just like a standalone, much like how they had the fighter one become a standalone.
Okay.
Beam Mage.
Okay, that's actually cool.
Go it alone or together with friends. There are tons of quests.
It might be free to play because I just saw it, like a meter that looked like
is a free start
might be like a time free to play.
Right away when it launches today.
Oh, it's out now. Or
next,
sometime today.
Kirby's Blowout Blast is also
ooh,
in
what?
3DS
system.
Okay, that's not what I thought it was.
Kirby is about to fight his way through a series of challenging 3D worlds. As you fight through 25 plus stages, the more enemies you inhale, the more firepower you wield. The stages are bigger.
So it's
than
like a shooter almost.
Wipe out entire troops of enemies all at once and go for a bronze, silver, or
it's
gold
like a puzzle
star
game,
when the game
it's like a Kirby 3D World shooter puzzle
least,
game.
A new multiplayer action game is in development for Nintendo 3DS systems. This
a new game's in development for 3DS.
Coming this holiday.
So you could say that 2017 is Kirby's big year.
Okay, why not Switch though?
Bye bye, Box Boy.
In an odd twist of fate,
you know, we don't know that. We just know this is going up for 3DS.
Alright.
Luckily, Kirby is no ordinary box. Adorable.
Hey, I heard this game's actually amazing.
Yeah.
Four new powers in the final game of the Box Boy trilogy. Create boxes to climb, hover, warp, and bomb your way to salvation. Do whatever it takes to solve more than 100 puzzles across 18 plus deadly worlds. And destroy the black smoke once and for all.
Box Boy for Smash.
Survive new hazards, beat new challenges, use new powers like the Box Rocket. Dress for success in Amiibo costumes.
Sure.
If you have save data of the first
only two Kirby, games, though.
You can play this one
is this Hal? Is that why?
Monochromatic filter.
Probably.
Try a demo for all three games today. And check out boxboy.nintendo.com for more info. Or better yet, just purchase and download your latest installment in the series. Created by Hal Laboratory,
yep,
the developers behind the Kirby series.
Bye Bye Box Boy launches today on Nintendo eShop and Nintendo 3DS.
Such a simple game. Can I figure out this head?
Hey, the leak was true.
Entries of the Legend of Zelda series will journey onto store shelves June 23rd.
Really? Plus, Skyward Sword?
Amiibo figures for Cloud, Corrin, and Bayonetta.
They said they were not going to do this. July 21st. Even though we knew.
July 21st.
In two versions.
Oh! Oh, I want them all! Both Bayonettas! Two Clouds! Female Corrin. That's the only gender swap. Right. They're the only next alternate costume ones. That's awesome. I gotta get them all now. They will all be mine.
Alright. Arms.
Hi there, ladies and gents. I'm Bip, your trusty Arms commentator.
Alright.
That's cool. Whose voice is that? Is that Matt Mercer?
I'm usually pretty quiet, but I'm always game to talk about Arms game.
I don't know.
The one with the weaponized extendable arms. So let's get into it. Now stay tuned, and always stay in arm's reach. So, couldn't resist. Yep, you guessed it. The biggest feature is the weaponry fighters attached to their fists, called arms.
No way!
There are standard...
The things attached to my fists are arms?
Multi-shot arms that really cause a ruckus. Specialized curving arms for cornering opponents. And powerful heavyweight class arms, just to name a few.
Whoa.
That's weird.
Each arm has a special attribute that activates when charged up. Light up your opponent to knock him down with fire. Stun and electrify your rival with lightning. Blow away the competition with a tornado of wind. And freeze your foe to slow him down with ice. You get the point. You want more, right? Perfectly normal. Try the Get Arms service, courtesy of the Arms League. The in-game currency you earn can be used for a chance to unlock new arms. The more you fight, the more arms you have in your arsenal.
To unlock the arms?
Arms on offer, and the fighters
those are hands, by the way.
There's only six characters.
Looks like it.
Girl who never flinches. The elusive ninja. One tough mummy. And my idol, Ribbon Girl. Their unique traits are as distinguished as the fighters themselves.
Oh, that's cool.
Not to mention, each one can mix and match any two available arms. That's right, fighting fans. The game gets deeper and deeper as players discover new combinations of fighters and arms. Now, get a load of this. Today, I'll give you a peek into how deep the strategy can get, and how much it depends on your own approach to arming and using a fighter in an actual match.
We're gonna see like a live match or something? Or a recorded live match?
Now, it's time to get amped up as I introduce to you a new contender, the Ramen Bomber!
Ramen!
Min-Min!
Huh. Okay. Ramen, sure. So there is more fighters.
Min-Min is one spicy new fighter.
You fight using ramen in martial arts. Okay. I don't know what that means.
She's cool.
She kicks.
Also kick down enemy attacks.
Oh, so like a parry. That's actually really cool.
Wait, you didn't think punches are the only attacks in arms, did you? That's one big misconception.
Flash kick.
Min Min is living proof of that. She can throw her opponent, and her left arm can transform into a dragon. This augmented arm can maintain a longer charge, so beat the sauce out of your rivals. So, anyone getting hungry? I wish my arms were made of noodles. Sorry, I lost myself.
She left-handed?
Next up is the enthusiastic Spring Man.
Okay.
After charging up, release to initiate a shockwave that can repel attacks with his overflowing energy and determination. His famous forte involves deflecting his opponent's punches, then delivering powerful counterattacks. When his health drops below 25%, his never-say-die attitude kicks in, and his punches will stay perma-charged.
Wow.
His slick-back spring hair isn't just for show. He actually gets stronger after bouncing back from a desperate situation.
I'm sure people will love that aspect.
I feel a fight coming. Guess I'll serve as your commentator. Let's see. Min Min has a fiery Ram Ram on the right and a fiery dragon on the left. She must have a hot temper. Spring Man has a fiery Slap-A-Mander on the right and an icy Chilla on the left. Huh, not sure where he's going with that.
Well, let's take up arms. Okay, here's Min Min right away. She's charging up, and there's her
stage.
Dragon arm. With her dragon arm and that dragon arm, it really looks like a real dragon. The dragon roasts opponents with a high-powered laser. There's a bit of delay before it fires, but its power is exceptional. She's got Springman cornered with her combo attacks, and a left, and a right, and a... Wait! Springman's counterattack has kicked in after deflecting a shockwave. Her dragon arm has no choice but to return to old ramen noodles. Both fighters continue to pummel each other. Ouch! He lands a right while dodging the laser. Min Min won't last if this keeps up. Carefully timing the gaps between punches is an important technique.
Seems interesting and all, but I just want another virtual arm. For the Switch. They are apparently making another virtual one.
Oh, is it for the Switch?
No, it's for PS4, and it's tied in with a light novel series. I don't know what to think.
Getting heated on the edge of the ramen bowl.
So everybody's an outboxer. Do they have any infighters? Someone character just runs in and just beats you up.
They probably would have the shortest.
Here comes the finisher. Wait, no! Instead, she avoids the counterattack with the guard. Talk about clarity under pressure. But just how much damage can her right arm take? Oh no, her right arm is down.
Oh no.
She's completely open to attack until she can. Yes, she manages to recover. Her kick is smacking down his arms, and now a simultaneous punch. Both fighters are desperately trying to recover their footing.
It's good that they're not all just the same character.
Yeah.
She has kicks, he has that power up, and
bam! He took that powered up dragon.
And then when his life is low,
yeah,
he gets stronger.
Springman's last hope is his special comeback. He'll never give up. Min Min has to finish this match before it's too late. Can she seal the deal?
His arm's down.
So does that mean when Springman eventually becomes playable in Smash Brothers, he'll have a counter?
No
extra rage. And, I don't know.
So how'd that strike you? From the fighters to their arms and abilities, there's an arsenal of techniques to unleash.
Seems interesting.
And the rivalry is heating up. Now that is arms.
And I'd like it to be a demo.
Rivalry, I'm not just talking about one-on-one matches. Sometimes you just gotta shake things up with some two-on-two action.
I don't even know how.
This seems like... ridiculous.
Yeah.
Adding up our long sleeves, so please stay tuned. Stretch the limits of your fighting skills when ARMS launches June 16th.
This is gonna be
until next time, fighting fans.
June. Technically, I think that's still spring.
Yeah.
Alongside the launch of ARMS, we'll release a new color of Joy-Con and Joy-Con strap, neon yellow.
I like the black and
we're also
yellow
releasing a
better.
Joy-Con attachment that extends the battery life.
Well,
when you want to play for a long time without charging.
Okay.
Speed run through some more headlines for Nintendo Switch.
That couldn't have just had more battery in general.
All right, time to speed run through some headlines.
Okay, Mario Kart.
All right.
I'm still not sure if I'm going to get this.
This is where they tell us that it's also got double dash mode, right?
Favorite racers and double items while introducing a huge battle mode featuring all new battle courses.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we know this.
More characters, carts, and tracks unlocked from the start than any Mario Kart game in series history.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
The online mode has a fun way of keeping things fresh. Choose race, and you'll join 11 other players and switch between random assortments of tracks.
Yeah, that was in the last one, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Everybody picks Rainbow Road.
And you'll even switch between modes, like good old balloon battles.
Okay, you can put in battle mode in that, too. That's cool.
For anything.
Okay.
For a more personalized experience, you can also play with friends in a friend room, where you pick the rules, the items, the CPUs, and
I don't think you make rules before.
You can create or enter a full-fledged
in-game
tournament. Speaking of, Nintendo will be hosting two of our own, one for racing and one for battle, to celebrate the launch of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe.
Okay.
Stay tuned for more info, because the race begins when the game launches April 28th.
Wow. That's
wait, wait, what?
That's, by the way, it's out.
Street Fighter 2, the final challengers, marks nearly 10 years since fans have seen a new iteration
of the
beloved.
Let me talk about that. Shooter mode?
One of the original fighters in all new HD graphics.
I don't think about this game, because they got rid of all the glitches that somewhat helped characters.
Oh, yeah?
Like, you can't keep certain motions stored on certain characters.
You can't say that.
You got four dashes?
See who reigns supreme in fierce local or online multiplayer competitions. For a change of pace, the all-new Way of the Hada mode lets you throw a Hadouken from first-person perspective.
You just fight a bunch of bison clones? Like his body?
I think.
Oh, they put dramatic battling?
Want to take it easy? Activate special moves with one button in head. Light battle feature. No matter what, take the fight with
now
you
I can do my T-Hawk 100% inescapable options slick with the touch of the screen.
Well, you can't do that when you play on the TV.
Popular games of all time is coming
Minecraft.
To the Switch. It's a game about placing blocks
Boy.
And going on
Switch adventure. Edition, huh? That makes sense.
I gotta say, build amazing things from the simplest home selling Microsoft buying this for $2 billion is probably still making them hand over fist. Unlimited resources. Or mind deep into they're like, whatever, we'll put on everything. Technically, it's already been on everything. The game was made in Java, so it could technically be played on anything.
They bought it like right before it came out on PS4, and then they were like, well, great, now we're not going to get on Nintendo consoles.
Yeah.
We've been perfect for Wii U. You can tap and do things. And then they came out, they didn't do anything with that.
Supporting both split screen and the Nintendo Switch Pro controller. Nintendo and Minecraft fans alike will also be happy to learn that the Super Mario Matcher Pack will be launching on the Nintendo Switch console. Play and explore a world full of classic characters and places from the Mario universe. Minecraft Nintendo Switch Edition, including the Super Mario Mashup Pack, will launch on Nintendo eShop May 11th and in stores at a later date. Happy building!
Okay. Good for people who like that.
Alright, awesome, so I see Sam Show right there in the picture.
Nintendo Switch.
Good for everyone. Over top, okay. Blazing Stars is a good game. Garo is coming out, wow, okay. Sam Show 4, but where's Sam Show 2? 99, alright. Galaxy Fight, that's good. Shock Troopers, first one's better, but alright.
Oh yeah, I'm looking forward to this one.
Sonic Forces?
Sonic Generations, but now there's three Sonics.
What?
We don't know who the third one is yet. Fight back. Eggman
Sonic.
1.
Sonic Adventure Song?
The blue blur, stylish, high-speed moves.
No, Sonic Generations.
Sonic the Animated Series Sonic?
And who is this alternate version of Sonic, summoned to this world by Eggman? Can he survive all the traps and return to his home world?
But wait, there's more. Sonic Boom Sonic, with his sarcasm.
Sonic yeah, they're gonna announce who it is at E3. But I'm guessing future Sonic. From the world where Eggman won, right?
There's one more Sonic speeding this
Oh yeah, me.
Yeah, I went
After
for this
more
one.
Than 20 years, a new installment in the classic series' original style is almost here. In addition to brand new stages, some popular
Well, this video is not doing it justice.
Souped up. Sonic Mania
looks kind of noisy.
On the Nintendo Switch this summer.
Yeah, the way they edit it.
Project Kuru is one big battle of an action game in which What's players this? Compete by flipping panels.
It's like
there's only one rule you need to
Power Man, are you butt slam?
Drop a panel and it'll change to your color.
Okay. Is this an indie game?
Fight to win by changing the most panels to your color and blow up your opponent.
So Bomberman meets Splatoon.
Sometimes flipping panels
Kinda?
Can yield items. They can boost your movement speed and panel flipping power.
Interesting.
Play with friends in 4-player local multiplayer. Or connect to the internet to face down opponents the world over.
Neat.
Look out for
yeah.
this title exclusively on Nintendo eShop for Nintendo Switch. This
it's probably indie game Nintendo paid.
Fate Extella is headed to Nintendo Switch.
Is this one like one of those other Fate extra
characters
games?
From the series?
Probably. It's like a rock, paper, scissors game, I think. Kind of.
Lead a
oh no, it's...
In a fight for
well, this isn't what I expected.
This intense action game.
Warriors.
With overwhelming power on your side,
Musou.
You'll crush thousands of enemies all by yourself.
When do these games get popular again?
Fate Extella will launch on July 25th.
Oh, and it's made by Exceed, so it's actually more like Senran Kagura.
Yes, when?
It's out. You can play it in English right now.
I know. I have it.
Oh.
But I kind of stopped playing it after a while. But now that's going to have all the DLC in it, and it's going to be portable.
Follow the princess overlord of the gorgeous netherworld, Seraphina.
It's like an extra story.
The demonic wanderer, Killian. On his quest for
I saw a lot of characters from other Disgaea games.
Of course, Axel's better for some reason.
And you can explore the
what is this?
To your heart's content when the standard and limited edition launches on Nintendo Switch.
Standard and limited? Well, May. That's yeah.
All right. So this is finally getting an American release despite being in Japan for like 2 or 3 years now.
While you're probably familiar with Tetris, you may be new to Puyo Puyo.
Nope.
A puzzle series
Not
that's
quite.
Downright famous in Japan.
Played it.
But hasn't been seen much.
It was on Dreamcast.
There's not a lot of things.
Tetris, pairs of Puyo fall from the top of your board and collect at the bottom. You'll move and rotate the Puyos, but unlike Tetris, your goal isn't to create a line. but to gather a clump of the same colored Puyos and clear them from your board.
The gameplay style has been popularized in other games since then.
Especially when you start setting up chains to drop garbage Puyo and sabotage your...
I wonder if Candy Crush ever tried to sue them, saying, "Hey, you stole our game idea." Sega's like, "Are you serious?"
Shortly after this presentation ends. The demo will give you a taste of both the solo arcade and multiplayer arcade modes. Unsure how to play?
I hear that
Lessons mode is included as well.
I hear that Tetris is like a little bit more overpowered than Puyo in this game.
Oh, yeah.
Which kind of makes sense, because if you hit like a 16-hit chain, they probably should have no way to escape it.
But yeah.
Now up to six players can enjoy Monopoly in a
for Switch.
New way.
Up to six players.
Hey, if you're a fan of that other game that you mentioned earlier.
Yeah, if you like Cult Sub Saga.
It even feels like the dice are rolling in your hand.
Whoa. I can feel the dice. I can also play Monopoly on the board.
And new rules that will...
You know what else you can feel dice and feel like you play Monopoly? Play Monopoly.
Oh, yeah, you know?
Plus, this probably has all the new rules that I don't like.
There's new rules?
Yeah, they make it easier and quicker and less
Rayman
fun.
Rayman Legends Definitive Edition is the ultimate version of the award-winning game.
Pick your Definitive Edition, huh?
Get absorbed once again into the mythical Blade of Dreams. The gang must run, jump, and smack their way through different worlds to save the day and discover the secrets of each legendary painting.
We're finally making an exclusive, like we said.
Switch, the Kung Fu experience now offers a solo mode and a tournament mode for pitting up to 8 teams against each other. You can also connect two consoles.
I think about it. I've never really been the biggest fan of Ubisoft games.
Get ready for a lot of laughs when the game launches later this year. If you're game for something different, then THQ Nordic has your back.
I already see what says on the bottom.
I'm not looking at it. I don't want to get spoiled.
Was co-developed by Grasshopper Manufacturer and Digital Reality. Find out what choices you'd make if you knew exactly...
Is this what you're trying to talk about at the Switch presentation? We went off script too much, so they couldn't translate it.
Complete with a local co-op in versus mode.
Touchdown Secret Flame.
Well, it looks like it. Grasshopper made the logo for it, at least.
Is an RPG inspired by console classics.
Such as?
It's based on the fan favorite Battle Chasers comic book series.
It's that game. I've heard about this.
And even deeper into its turn-based combat when the game releases
like the visual style
Nintendo
so far.
This was crowdfunded, I believe.
Yeah.
Getting paid to be the bad guys is as sweet of a
thing. Getting
paid
to?
Really?
Two for Nintendo Switch.
Okay, let's do this.
You and three other players can band together for intense co-op action and rise to the top of the criminal underworld for bigger jobs.
Is John Wick still in it?
Was he in it?
Yep.
To customize your character with new skills that change the...
He was like a free DLC character.
A huge amount of Payday 2 content will be released on Nintendo Switch. So it'll be high time to open this vault later this year.
Alright, what's next?
Some of the most popular Namco games of all time are headed to Nintendo Switch.
There's no virtual console,
Namco
so...
Museum. You can play classics like Pac-Man, Galaga, or Splatterhouse.
Oh wow, Splatterhouse? Really?
And multiplayer favorites like Rolling Thunder, Sky Kid, and Tank Force.
Is Splatterhouse?
Local co-op with family and friends.
I mean, it's on this.
You can use the standard horizontal...
I remember Rolling Thunder.
Or even switch to a vertical layout for that classic arcade feel.
Yes!
Stop and resume your game...
Oh, Legend of Atari Drago.
Oh, was that ever in America?
Yeah.
Fun challenge mode designed for each game.
It is hard.
The classic fun begins when Namco Museum comes to Nintendo eShop on Nintendo Switch.
Was it Namco? I'm still trying to figure that out, because I thought it was a title
that
game?
Limited quantities
could be wrong.
Of the standalone Nintendo Switch dock will be available for purchase May 19th. You can hook up an extra dock to a separate TV.
Oh,
you can switch from one to the other without unplugging your main
Switch.
Set. If you're interested,
one to the other.
If you're lazy and don't feel like unplugging stuff and plugging stuff back in.
Does it come with a charger? All right.
Grab three of your best Inkling teammates and fire up your Wii U console. Because Battlefy is hosting the Splatoon US Inkling Open, the online event you've been waiting for.
Okay.
If you're 18 years or older and...
This is on the original one.
You can register your team at battlefy.com.
Ah, it's for Wii U.
Where you'll also find details, rules, and tournament times. Who knows? If you splat with the best of them, you may even win a trip to E3 2017.
Is that it? You're not going to say anything else about Splatoon 2?
Well, let's dive into our last game of the day. Splatoon 2.
Yeah, they're going to finish on Splatoon 2.
Okay. Alright.
Grizzco?
Some 90s, 80s style tapes.
And that's what they're going for with Splatoon, kind of, right?
I don't know if they were, but they think that's what they've grasped on that they wanted.
Yeah.
Power eggs. That's what
is that the plot? Is that the plot thing? Power eggs?
Better future for tomorrow. I like the MIDI. The old MIDI sequence.
Is this a recruitment video?
Yeah. All skill levels. Look, he's got gloves and everything.
Yeah, look at that outfit.
Oh! We can accomplish anything.
Is that what you wear in the new story mode?
You're a fisherman?
The greater your reward. Or is this a new mode entirely?
At Grisco Industries. Yeah, maybe this decimated the Octolings. It's like a hiring video. Grisco.
Are your regulatory systems functioning?
It is a new mode. Okay.
Is it going to be four player? Four player co-op? Yeah.
That's what I wanted. Maybe startling.
Like Phantasy Star Online is what I wanted, honestly.
You may be wondering about the Squid Research Lab. Well, we research squids in a lab. And other things too, like that strange video. Perhaps what you saw seemed a bit unusual. But research indicates that freelance power egg collection is becoming quite popular among
englands collect power eggs in single player.
Salmon run.
Yeah.
Salmon run?
Luckily, one of our fearless researchers went on location and captured this curious activity live on camera. Now, we share our findings with the world. For the first time on film, we can see this remote location, separated from Inkopolis, on the other side of the ocean. This derelict man-made island is a hotspot for freelance power egg collectors. Amazing! Inklings super jumping to the island! We concluded that four Inklings make a team, just like in Turf War.
Okay.
What are they wearing? Implications! It looks like some kind of special gear provided just for this task. And it appears they're given weaponry too.
It's like a horde mode?
It's a power egg collector's job to defeat creatures of the salmonid genus who habitually attack for some unknown reason. It's not just one way.
Which yeah, is a okay.
When you're collecting power eggs.
Can you upgrade?
As you can see, they can be acquired from debilitated salmonid. It may sound easy, but in. What's this? Some sort of salmonid. To tell the truth, it's unlike anything we've ever seen. Just wait till I
see it. Salmonids? Is that what they're calling
them? Yeah.
That's it. It's a special kind of boss salmon.
It's like fish people?
A bounty to hunt. I'm afraid our brave squid friends are no match for this beast. At least, not with their current strategy.
Oh no.
One of the Inklings is down.
Oh no.
And another. Yet somehow, the incapacitated Inkling has deployed a lifesaver to call for help. Oh, I see. When a fallen freelancer gets inked by an ally, that Inkling can be resuscitated.
Ah,
freelancing does have its benefits. Communication is key, because Inklings that work together win together. Unless they don't. What an honor it is to witness this incredible struggle.
How this is interesting. Odd.
These eggs have a rare appearance, even among power eggs. Could they be golden eggs? And now it looks like the Inklings are transporting these golden eggs to a containment unit in the center of the site. Aha! Could it be that this is the freelancer's ultimate objective? To harvest these golden eggs and haul them to Inkopolis?
Oh, man.
Indeed, after many trials and tribulations, the Inklings have collected their golden egg prize and fulfilled their corporate agenda. What we witnessed here is the harsh reality of one suspicious part-time job.
What the heck is that thing?
Such a dismal occupation be so popular among Inklings.
Oh, there are a lot of enemies that show us very quickly.
Well, it might be due to the rewards. I've heard they're quite, fresh, is it? More research may be required.
So what do you get?
Question mark.
What a day for science. If we compile any new information, you will be the first to know.
That's
We're
cool.
We're planning to release a research report on the ongoing battle with Octarians, so stay tuned and stay fresh. That reminds me, we have one last report for you. It's a scientific fact that new Splatoon 2 series amiibo will be released. There are three new figures.
Okay.
Inkling Girl, Inkling Boy, and Inkling Squid.
Okay.
It's only slightly
when
different.
When you tap these amiibo, the figure character will appear in-game and befriend you.
boy and girl look cool, but the squid's pretty much the same.
Befriend an amiibo character, and they'll remember your favorite outfits, weapons, gear.
Ah, so this is what I was wondering about. You can probably bring this if they're going to have tournaments. And you can go, swap your outfit. This is what I want. This is my loadout.
I'd imagine it comes in handy when waging turf wars at a friend's house.
For that.
Okay.
To conduct your own research, try snapping a photo with your amiibo friend. That way you can both wear your favorite outfits.
Just hanging out in squid form.
Then you can share your photos with human friends on social media via the Nintendo Switch album. Sometimes your amiibo friend may give you special gear as a gift.
Huh.
Whoa, that's an interesting one.
The game is compatible with previously released Splatoon amiibo figures as well.
Cool.
I have all those.
Yeah, me too.
I kind of want to get the alternate colors ones, though.
I got the girl's alternate color.
Today's I want to get all the alternate colors, but I don't know if they actually do anything different.
No, they don't.
You don't know that, though.
Forgive my apparent short-term memory loss. They do. I have one last fact for you. Splatoon 2 launches July 21st.
Okay.
Oh.
And the new amiibo release that same day.
Okay. Well,
makes sense.
That's all for today's report. Squid Research Lab, signing off.
His new inkling was pretty cool.
I hope you enjoyed this new sliding. Thanks for watching.
Well, now I got more stuff to go buy.
That's it?
I guess so.
Okay. Well, that was the Nintendo Direct. We learned some stuff.
Yeah.
We got concrete release dates for ARMS and Splatoon. When was ARMS? April?
June. April was Mario Kart.
April was Mario Kart, that's what it was.
Comes out in 10 days. Or not 10 days, less than 10 days. Right. Or more than 10 days, sorry. Like 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Today's the 11th? The 12th? 13th?
Yeah.
12th. It's right there on the screen.
So yeah, we got Mario Kart coming out this month. We got ARMS in June. And we got Splatoon in July, they said?
Yeah.
What was the one that was super close that we were surprised by? Was it Mario Kart?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
It was the 28th.
Did they say the sky?
I don't remember.
They did, I think. I just don't remember what it was. We learned some new 3DS games. We learned that they're still making Kirby games for 3DS.
Yeah.
Which I find a little odd.
I feel like it's just an easy game to probably make, especially with all the resources they've already thrown into it right now.
But see, what I really want is 3DS level games on Switch.
Yeah.
Like, bad graphics and all. Like, I want that on Switch.
Yeah, it'd be fine. You know, I don't think anybody'd complain about
it. Yeah, just make it like $40, like same price as 3DS game.
Especially with, like, how the 3D and the touchscreen seem to be less important.
Oh, it looks like it might be using that new Kirby 3D game. Because, like, a lot of levels are, like, looking down. They might, you know, you gotta jump on different levels. In order to arc your shots better, it might be better to do it in 3D.
Maybe.
Kind of like that Link Between Worlds. They use 3D a lot, and that's pretty much the same way. But yeah, that new Kirby game looks cool. It's cool that they're making that RPG Kirby game into a full thing, or more of a thing. There's that new Mii game coming out 3DS, which looks cool. That card game you mentioned.
Yeah, it holds up.
Anything else?
Monopoly's coming out, but...
Yeah, Monopoly on Switch.
Well, like, it's cool, and, like, I would like to play Monopoly, but I'd rather have Fortune Street hit the States and then play that instead. Mm. Or Cold Sip. Cold Sip's pretty cool.
ARMS is cool. We got a new character. We learned of a four-player mode and a bit more details about how the fighters are going to be different from each other.
So, I'm pretty interested in the fact that Splatoon announced that their official tournament from the one that exists, and they show off the amiibo feature showing, hey, if you want to play at a friend's house, you know, you can bring your amiibo. Mm. But obviously, the big issue with, like, in Japan or anywhere if they had a tournament, it's like, oh, I can't, you bring my own system. And, like, you can here, obviously, but even so, you can keep your loadout on an amiibo? So I'm thinking that they're probably going to go really hard on, like, the esports area with Splatoon this time, because we got spectator mode, we have 8-player local, you know, online, and again, this everything that it's kind of pointing towards, like, they tested it first, it did really well in Japan, and people like it in America, so they're probably thinking esports are on the rise. I think they're trying to get a piece of the pie.
I think time played an element, but also, like, Overwatch kind of died it down a bit. Like, it was out for a while. It had a pretty strong summer, and a bit of fall, and then I think it, by spring it died down a little bit.
Yeah.
But then they added more stuff, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm hoping 2 will re-grab people.
Yeah.
Splatoon is a great game. And that new, what was it called? The Salmon Run? Salmon Run mode looks really fun.
It looks interesting.
I'm really looking forward to that. I'm a little it looks like the amiibo can only be used to save. I was hoping they'd be come with extra content.
It might. We don't know that for sure.
Well, they said that the previous amiibos were going to be compatible too, so maybe those will give you, maybe those costumes will carry over.
Maybe.
That's what they'll do? I don't know. But they all look cool. I'm not crazy about the purple squid one because it just looks like the regular one.
I don't really care. I'm fine with that too.
I don't know, but the Inkling ones look really cool. I was kind of hoping for a new Callie Marie ones, like wearing whatever they're going to wear in the next one.
Well, we've only seen the back of Marie and none of Callie.
I was hoping to see what they were going to be in this one, and then we'd get their amiibos. But that still might happen. They just had maybe same for E3.
I hope.
We obviously didn't get that. I was expecting them to detail how online mode's going to work.
Yeah.
On the Switch in general. But I guess that's going to be E3.
I hope we can wear the horrible giant gloves and the coveralls. Oh, yeah, I want to play in that because that doesn't look cool at all.
You could unlock the one player mode costume in the first game.
Yeah.
So it would make sense that maybe you can unlock the goofy, what was it, Grizzo?
Oh yeah.
Corporation salmon fisherman clothes.
Yeah.
That would be cool. Yeah. The life preserver. I wonder if that is like a specialty ability in the main game at all.
I don't think it will be, but I do think maybe there's a mode where, like, maybe they'll have, like, 4-on-4. When you get knocked out, you're knocked out, but you can be picked back up.
Because, you know, a lot of 4-player co-op games have a mode where, like, pick you up, oh, okay, yeah, you're back to some health. Or
like Gears or something like that, you know. When you get downed, they can finish you off, or, you know, you can get picked back up by your allies. So it'd be cool if they had that where it was, like, more of like a deathmatch mode, but you have one life, but your team can save you.
Because that's a cool thing, and I would like to see that used in other places, but maybe for this game, maybe in 3, they'll be like, more modes that use this, or maybe down the line, like, they'll add to this game.
They're always adding to Splatoon,
sure.
So I'd imagine they'd be even more ambitious with Splatoon 2.
Well, I also hope that they come out the gate with more stuff than the first one did.
Well, it seems like they will.
I mean, they're adding a whole new mode right now.
I feel like they'll have all the old modes. Probably that mode, a couple other new ones, but even more coming down the line.
How many levels do you think?
Out the gate?
Yeah.
I'd probably say like at least.
Because we've seen 4 or 5, I think. Maybe 6 now with this, and I didn't notice.
I'd say a decent chunk, probably 12. They'll probably bring back some old stages later as well.
Well, in the first trailer they announced it, they showed a couple old levels, but they had new stuff in it, like those bars that you can go through.
Yeah.
Like an old level had that in it. So they might remix the old levels in some way.
I hope that there's a way you can also create your own open online rooms.
Oh, like custom?
So you could choose what mode you want to play without having to have everybody on your friends. It's like people can jump in.
It looks like they're adding that to Mario Kart, which is great.
Mm-hmm.
I remember hearing a lot of people complain that they can't... Either no items are like the only thing they could really change before. So hopefully they'll have like really minute, like you can change this detail. You can only have this weapon.
Yeah.
Kind of thing. Yeah, that would be cool. Well, that was us watching Nintendo Switch. Thank you for watching us watch this. Please do whatever you want, and hopefully that will include liking this video, subscribing, leaving a comment. It could also include disliking. We won't hate you if you do that. I mean, we will secretly, but we won't hold it against you.
What's your opinion?
Yeah, your opinion. Your opinion is fine. I was pretty satisfied with this Direct, mostly though because I'm expecting to be blown away at E3.
I hope so. They said they were going to come big at E3, didn't they?
That's what they said.
Which they haven't for like the last 3 or 4 years.
Yes, they have not. So I'm hoping, and we're probably going to hear more about, they're probably going to announce a new character for ARMS and some new modes for Splatoon or something.
E3 does happen before Splatoon, but does it come out before ARMS?
Oh.
I don't think it does.
No, because ARMS is June something.
Yeah.
And E3 is June something.
Yeah, so
it'll probably... If ARMS comes out before E3, they'll probably still talk about ARMS.
Yeah, I mean, they'll probably talk about maybe content or stuff.
But I'm guessing they're waiting to talk about how much and how exactly online modes are going to work for E3, which, fine. I was kind of expecting this Direct to do that. since ARMS and Splatoon 2 are going to be pretty online heavy, I think.
Yeah.
But we gotta see. We'll see. Oh yeah, and new Zelda amiibos. Whether they got Majora's Mask Link, they got Twilight Princess Link, and then they got Skyward Sword. So that's cool. That's cool.
Oh yeah, that one Bomberman looking game.
Oh yeah, that indie game.
Project Mercury or something like that.
Something like that. Yeah, that looked cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, looking forward to that too. All right, thank you for watching. Goodbye.